Dia. Bapak besar. Yari, jangan sebut persis. Ya, jatuh. Our sources that they have been knocking on from the wheels. We open by fire. You have been believing God for this miracle. You have been asking God, show me favor, show me mercy. And you look as if the favor and the mercy is not forthcoming. I came back God to tell the child of God, the favor has come. Your time has come.
Amen.
I came back God to announce to you, your time is now.
Amen.
You serve a God. You serve a mighty God. He's the same yesterday. He's the same today. He's the same forever. When God said yes, when God lift you up, when I can bring you back, God is on your side. God is on your side. This moment is on your side. God is on your side. This moment is on your side.
Amen.
Who is that mortgaging your destiny? Heaven is about to foster the person. Who is that person that have right for sale at your back? When you have not noticed that, by the authority of heaven, judgment is coming against that person. I don't care to know the person that vows that your family will never have rest of mind. I don't know the man who hit hand on the ground and say over his dead body that your family will not rest. I come by God as an oracle of God, as God's servant, as the man servant of God. That same person shall die.
Fire!
Whether it is your mother,
fire!
whether it is your auntie, whosoever it may be, sitting down on your success, and refuse to get up. That put a limit and said that nobody will cross the limit.
Fire!
I don't want the man in your village that does not want anybody to climb to challenge him financially.
Fire!
And thereby the person put a charm and said, nobody will even cross this level. The cross of the thing to where I am. Today, that particular limitation.
I jump and pass.
Sit down. Amen.
Amen.
I hope you are with me.
Yes, sir.
When a man's time comes, God will make his enemy to be at peace with him.
Yes, sir.
Once your time comes, when your time comes, God will provoke heavenly angels to fight your battle, even when you did not pray. Amen.
Amen.
When your time comes, even when you did not pray, even when you have prayed and prayed and prayed and prayed and you failed, in fact, let me prepare myself for the next prayer I'm going to pray. Or you are confused to pray. When your time comes, God will mobilize some angels, warriors of fire. They will carry heavenly God martial sword. Enter your father's compound and say, who did do this, my brother? Sir. Who be you wasting his destiny? Sir. Who be you wear his success? Sir. Can I tell you something? You don't know the people that is dealing with you, but the Holy Ghost knows them. Holy Ghost carry sword that is socketed in the fire and dipped in the blood of Jesus. Enter my kindred. Enter my father's compound. Enter my father's lineage. Enter where my mother comes from. Anybody that is supposed to die that is alive, eating the destiny of others. Holy Ghost, keep the person.
Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen.
Because I saw in a prayer, in the spirit of prayer, under cancer, a woman had been using his children for swearing. She has 8 children. She's a witch. Each time it is her time to die, she will donate one of her child. The child will die, she will die. She donate and donate and start donating her grandchildren. And one day, she chopped one of his sons, that's the radical. He chopped one of the child. The boy says, no, this nonsense will stop. Other seed, they keep quiet about me, I will not keep quiet. They enter water and go to the village and say, Mama, if you come to my house again, I will kill you. Mama said, what do you mean? He said, I have just come to warn you. Because prophecy has given to him that what is happening to you, your mama know. She just went around and warned the woman, come back. The child fell, another one fell sick again. She got come back and said, and the child got surprised and said, your mother know what is happening to your child. He said again, prayer was given to him. He collected the prayer. He went home and called up. He said, man of God, I will do the fast now. But I know my problem. Let me solve my problem. Personally. The entire motto went to the village, sat his mother down, and said, Mama, you see that place? Now we are going to bury you. He said, you get back to me. It is an error for me to die. You will start alive. He said, Mama, I warned you before. And yet you still come to my house again to attack my child. But today, before my child will die, I will kill you first.
He said, I'm not going to go, but go back to Lagos. That's how he said. I don't know anything more, but go back to Lagos. Your child is free. And she called other people, was telling them, they were abusing him. How you call him mama? A witch, a real mama. But the first daughter knew what her mother is. That one said, I don't doubt you. Brothers may not understand, but me, I understand. And that's why people come and say, Mama, if you are dealing with others, deal with them, but me and this one, if you cross, we will kill you. Then that one come back to Lagos and started having his prayer. Fire prayer, fire prayer. That was when I was using my hands for counseling. Fire prayer, fire prayer. Her mother right hand swelled up. He continued to fire prayer. The woman that is where they used to go to phone booth and make call. Called him and said, come back. I mean, come to this. I want to give you something. He said, I'm not coming until you die. He said, no, I don't want to die. I want to hand you over something so that I will be free. And the boy went home. They carried one small clay pot. Gave him. I said, break it. And stop tormenting. Your name don't come out. But others, I don't believe them. And the boy carried it in. He said, what would I do? He said, break. The boy smashed that. Do you know what came out? This cockroach that used to be in the village, that used to have thick back, that used to smell. That cockroach, that black one, that used to smell very well. That was what is inside that. As the thing moved, the man said, yes, run free. The boy carried through. Was hitting the cockroach. The more you hit the cockroach, the more the cockroach you did run. The boy was hitting the cockroach. The cockroach refused to die. He entered inside and used cutlass. Ta! Continued to do. I say, move again. Carry both of them inside fire. Wow. Come back to heavens. Stop open. I don't know who is sitting on you. There is a prayer that can provoke the hidden things that you don't know. From my heart of prayer. Everybody will know who you are. Whether you know the person or you do not know the person. Sit down. I don't have much time today. I'm going to do everything possible to see. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Are you with me?
Yes.
Praise God.
Hallelujah.
I am begging God to go around, search for anything that belongs to you.
Amen.
I'm returning back to you.
Amen.
I am happy to tell you, child of God, whatever you lost before is coming back today.
Amen.
Before 6 o'clock this evening, you are lost. Ability shall be your hand. Whatever you lost shall be in your hand. Whatever you lost shall be in your hand. Favor will speak for you. Even in the midst of battles and war and confrontation, favor will speak in your life. You will no longer be an object of ridicule.
Amen.
You will no longer be an object of caricature.
Amen.
Your time has come because heaven is about to smile on you.
Amen.
Your enemies will no longer frustrate you anymore.
Amen.
No longer shall people look at you and tell you your time has gone. Because after now, heaven will announce you.
Amen.
And heaven does not need permission of your enemies to announce you. When God wants to announce you, he makes sure that he kills whosoever that will oppose you. In the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Sit down. When it was the time of Samuel to be announced, God organized war. Carry Ophini and Phinehas. Put them in the battlefield. Both of them died. And they returned back with bad news. Tell your father, Eli, your two sons are dead. And the ark of the covenant has been captured. The man fell down, broke his spinal cord, and died. And the wife of one of the son that was pregnant, a baby boy, went into labor and delivered a premature child. And they called that one Ichabod. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
Amen. And I'm sure that the child also died. Because if the child lives, they will tell the man, the someone, wait, he has a son. When the son grew up, he will talk about the father's position. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Amen and amen.
Amen.
So I don't know who has been sitting on the throne of your prosperity. Can I tell you something, child of God? In the spiritual realm, if you want to be successful in life, every human being have a throne where you sit to command the world. Every human being have a throne where you sit and the world will be coming to you on their own. And if somebody sit on that throne of your prosperity, you are gone. You are not an answer, you are gone. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
I don't know if you understand me. If somebody eventually maneuver you and sit on that your seat of prosperity, you will be moving from pillar to post, from post to pillar, from one place to another without achieving anything. But if God gives you grace to sit on your seat of prosperity, you will see things happening on their own very easy. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
So what am I trying to tell you? I don't know who has sitting on your seat of prosperity. See, to know a person who somebody has taken over the seat of his prosperity, you may have opportunities, but all the opportunity will come and go. You'll be looking at the opportunities. It will be coming before you, hitting you and going away from you. Most of the times, if they want to do something tangible that will fetch money, they will use you, start it from the scratch. You will scrap the plan, crawl and crawl, and get to a level where you have solved the most difficult part. They will cheat you and bring somebody again. Have anybody noticed something like that? They will shift you and bring somebody in. You are the one that started this from the scratch. Solve the difficult part of the things. The area that is very, very difficult. As you have finished the whole thing, raise something out of nothing. They will bring somebody that don't know anything. The person will step in and start. At the end, they will tell the person, we hear you. We hear you. Today, it will not happen again. I say it will not happen again.
Amen.
By the power of the Most High, by the power of the resurrected Jesus, it ends today.
Amen.
I didn't hear an encouraging amen. I said it ends today. In the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Many of us that always see opportunity, people will use you, bring you and tell you that how do we do this? How do we have? Look at this thing. How can we do it? You will get the best idea. You will not know that the person is using your idea. You move. Tell me, how do we do this thing? He said, if you put it this way, it will work. But if you put it this way, it will not work. The person will sit down. If you see your brain, you will give them the best idea. We say, okay, no problem. Go. I will call you later. The highest thing the person will give you, 1,005 or 2,000. This is for your transport. When I need you, I will call you. And you will not hear from the person again. Most of us, people don't call you when they are enjoying. They will only call you in a time where there is something to labor about. That means they have collected favor from you and give you labor. Anybody here that have lost favor and they give you labor, it is ending today.
Amen.
Brothers, don't mind me, no. I need you to shout this amen so that you will testify. I say it is ending today.
Amen.
In Jesus' name I pray. Sit down. I used to say this thing. The worst thing that can happen to a man is when your wife being in the position of providing. The worst thing that can happen to a man is when your wife be in the position of providing. Your wife will pay children's school fees, Your wife, we be the one that is providing food in the house. Your wife, we be the one to pay the school, the house rent. Your wife will be the one that will even give you transport fare to go out. If you want to go and say, honey, just for the very last time, 1,000. Just give me 1,000 for the very last time. Every time for the very last time. When will that last time come? Today, if that thing is disturbing you, I stand on my ground. I command that cause to be broken before Sisu ground. In the name of Jesus Christ. There is this kind of people. This type of people. People don't remember them when they have. People only remember you when they are broke. That one that happened to me before, not now. Anybody who is sick will say, ah, brother, I don't finish everything where I get before the finance see you. Before they land directly to you. Ah, I don't spend my money, don't really before I know you. You pay me say my money don't pay before I know you. Why you don't know me that I wear money then? Ah? Is anybody experiencing something like that? They will only remember you when the thing don't finish. They will come to you and they will still need you to advise them, need you to tell them the best thing. And when you give them advice and show them a way, that thing you show them will work for them. They will tell you, ah, don't worry, we will get back to you. It is ending today. In the name of Jesus. I said in the name of Jesus. Can I tell you something? Among the charms that a woman do and the charms that a man do, the charm that is more dangerous is the one that a woman do. Amen? If woman they tie you, they will tie you so thick, your mama not going to recognize you. But if man they tie you, they will tie you so you cannot be able to feed your family. Amen? But if woman they tie you, he will tie you no money, no family, nothing. You will be a beggar. In fact, now your wife will feed you. Let's pass then and your wife will feed you. You will come get ego. From that ego, you will put sickness. From sickness, eye problem. From eye problem, ear problem. From ear problem, knees problem. From knee problem, stroke. Women, their heart. Some of them are not all of them. Some of them, their heart is under their leg. If they are handling you, if they are handling you, you better go to the devil to handle you. Now some of them to handle you. Amen? If man that attack you, they attack you, make you not come up like him. But still, there's some men who will get the heart of witch. Praise the Lord. I was opportune to lay hand on a particular man. I kept to pray for him, and the Lord said, this young man is suffering 7 types of sickness. Dangerous, dangerous one. And I said, sir, I see this couple. He said, I'm asthmatic. I said, yeah. I see another thing, your blood pressure. He said, I'm a he have high BP. Praise the Lord. I said, why? I see you touching your stomach. He said, he gets ulcers. Dangerous, dangerous sickness. I said, what am I doing? He said, he gets partial stroke. Dangerous, dangerous sickness. I said, how many children? No charge. I said, no charge. He said, yes. He gave me close by now. Dangerous one. Amen.
Amen.
I said, okay, only you one. He said, yes, sir. Yes. I said, it's it. Everywhere. Step up. I said, how do you survive? He said, if I get 10,000 now, drugs. Amen.
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 If you don't know what is happening, the root of your problem, you will not know what is happening. And if you don't handle it, you will die like that. But it's not our portion. Jesus will show us way out.
Amen.
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 Somebody is about to recover something.
Amen.
open your Bible. Open your Bible to the book of Genesis chapter 43, 19 to 23. Are you there?
Yes, sir. Amen.
Amen.
Book of Genesis, chapter number 43. I read verses 19 to 21. And I read in Jesus' name. And they came near to the steward of Joseph's house, and they communion with him at the door of the house, and said, we came indeed down at the first time to buy food, and it came to pass when we came to the inn that we opened our sack, and behold, every man's money was in the mouth of his sack.
Everyone's what?
Money.
Everyone's money. In the mouth of his sack. Underline that, please. In the mouth of his sack. He said, we came here to buy something, but it came to pass as we got home, we opened the sack and we find out that everyone's money is in the mouth of the sack.
Our money in food, and we have put it again in our hand.
Yes.
We have brought it again in our hand. That's enough.
Amen.
Amen.
Okay. Now listen. I pray that the word of God will kind of fire.
Amen.
It will come from like authority.
Amen.
It will bring revival and restoration.
Amen.
In Jesus' name.
Amen.
It will work for you.
Amen.
And work for me.
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
How many of us have lost opportunities? How many of us have lost opportunities? You have lost opportunities. God bless you. There they are. How many of us have lost money? You did something of money hand. You invest money into something and it hand. How many of us? Okay. There they are. Can I tell you something? Some of those money will return back after today.
Amen.
I'm not just saying it. I don't know how it's going to happen, but I see it in the Bible. The Bible tells me. Amen? And I stand with you 100% assurance. In fact, all of you gathered here, even if you put your faith together, you don't believe that you want to have now. So I stand in 150% faith assurance. If you lost that money, including me, it will come back.
Amen.
Jesus' name.
Amen.
Do you know how I know it will come back? The Bible says, we came to buy in Egypt. In Egypt. Egypt means the world. Egypt means the foreigners. Egypt means the people that never know God. Egypt are heathens. Egypt are people that never have regard to God. He said, if you lost your money anywhere, through enemies, and he said, in the land of Egypt, they went there to buy, and as they were returning, they got them, opened their sack, and find each person money at the mouth of the sack. He said, sir, to our greatest surprise, 1 naira was not missing, the exact amount. Can I prophesy to someone?
Yes, sir.
That moment that you do something with somebody and the money hang, that exact amount, 1 naira shall not miss out of it, it will return back to you. See that? Amen. Do you know how I know it will return? He said, at the mouth of the sack. Meaning, the mouth of the sack means you will declare it with your mouth. Amen. When you declare it with your mouth, it will return with just my muscle 1 naira. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Amen.
And he said, and now we have returned here with the money. We have it on our hand. Praise the Lord. Whatsoever you have been looking for, the money that you invested into something at its hand, if you can see that it's not coming, you have prayed and fasted, and if you can see that the money is not coming, hear me today, hear me well. By the power of the Most High, I came here, I came by the Almighty. That money that is hanging shall return by fire. I have a God who can travel to any means, who can travel to anywhere to recover the money. The money is not lost because there is Jesus moving around to recover the money. You can serve a dead God, for serve a mighty God. He's the same yesterday, he's the same today, he's the same forever. When God said yes, no one can say no. When God leads you, no one can bring you down. Is on your side.
Amen.
Is on your side. Amen. This money is on your side. Is on your side. The person will not eat the money. I see the money returning back. I see your wealth returning back. I see your success returning back. I see your star returning back. I see your star returning back. Somebody shout fire. Yeah, 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 yeah. Return by the word of declaration of the mouth. When you declare it, you will have it in your hand. What does that mean? You will see evidence.
Amen.
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 See, evidence brings encouragement.
Yes, sir.
When you see evidence, it breaks and destroys the spirit of doubt.
Yes, sir.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Amen.
Like what happened some time ago. Here, a prophecy was given to a young guy here. And God said, the guy recognized that. After the prayer, he was going home. God favored him. From here, God started from here. Favored him with about 30,000.
Yeah, that's 4,000.
Okay. Favored him from here. And he went to the church to testify, to his church to testify. From that 70,000, somebody let him give him 10,000. We go for 70,000. He went to testify to the church, and somebody stand up and said, I'm going to take you to Germany. Praise the Lord. But I'm not here to testify. He testified here. If you are here today, you testify. Raise your hand. Okay, God bless you. So I'm not lying. And somebody stood up and said, as you are testifying, the Spirit of God asked me to take you to Germany. And another person started by saying, as you are taking him to Germany, I will pay for his flight ticket. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Amen.
And he came back here to testify. And they went to the embassy to submit his passport and other things. As soon as they got there, they said, this young man don't give visa here 2 weeks ago.
I never come here before.
They said your visa has been here 2 weeks ago. And they calculated that 2 weeks is what that Tuesday we pray for him here. Amen.
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 And they said, okay, there's a magic room. Please, can you come? They took him to that place. They're asking some questions. They said, see your visa don't come out.
The man said, I never come here.
When did you come? I know they come here. They say, is there any time in your life you appear here? He said, 1987. 1987. Isn't that what he said? 1987. That he came. It narrated he was taking of a woman, that the children wanted to take me to an abroad. It's US.
Yes, yes.
UK. Okay. As they were preparing the thing, they get to embassy. They have preached everything, get to embassy. They were mentioning his name. They said, this man has traveled yesterday. The man said, I never traveled to Sydney here now. He said, no, you traveled yesterday. The man said, this one happened 1987. The man said, I don't travel to Sydney here now. He said, wait. They brought the manifest of the people that traveled yesterday. His name was there. Satanic manipulations. He showed his name among the people that traveled yesterday. And the man said, I fear you. I beg the driver, take this man back to Imo State. You're not going anywhere again. And the prayer was said here. After the prayer, the passport and visa of 1987 surfaced. According to what he said, I know for I'm going to need to say that. He said, according to what he said, they said to him, look at your passport and your visa. He said, but I'm not going to UK. I'm going to Germany. He said, no problem. We're going to change it from UK visa to Germany visa. The 2 days I change it in, immediately come and say, see your visa. Praise the Lord. It was not about, and the day they were about to fly, the wife escorted him to the airport with the young man, and the man looked at her and said, I guess you're missing your husband. He said, yes. The man brought out a check, write one thing, gave to her, and said, go and catch it. The sister looked, opened it, and smiled and moved and was happy. You know, do you know how much it is? He said, 1 million. He said, what? He said, 1 million. His sister said, that's funny. Amen. But now we never see the woman again. We don't see her. Okay, now. Okay. Amen. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
According to what the husband testified, I know that there are different man testify here. Praise the Lord. Shall I tell you this?
Yes.
Hear me, child of God. And another choking one happened at Ajegunle. Somebody on the program, Monday program, after program, the student said, they have told him. It's a decree of prophesy that somebody is going to receive a miracle that will make him or her to cry. I will prophesy. Now me prophesy. It did not happen to me. He leave me go happen to one sister who come for the first time that day. I nearly cry. Look, I nearly cry. I cry. This my son, my God, cry. Even the one that went out happened to organize that uncle. Here I go out. Refuse to eat in the house. Amen. That one I cry because me, I went back out from where I live. And I tell God, this place, I don't like it again. Look at the house. I want to go before the house will fall. Amen. And then his sister said, you don't do any business with anybody. You don't do anything. I don't know how possible this one is. At least I have some bankers here. I have a banker. If I don't know, I have one person. I have one banker here. I don't know how that happened. I don't know how possible it is for this kind of a thing to happen in a bank. The woman said, as soon as we dismiss out of the bread, she stepped out. She received an alert on her phone. There is an alert you receive here. Don't bother yourself at 20,000. Amen. There's one you will receive here. That one comes small. Like 50, 60. Amen. There's a one you will receive here. Now about 200,000 to 300,000. But there is an alert you will receive. When you hear, this one is here, give it. I want to hear. But this one, the man, the woman says, here, give it. The alert, this one is not 1 million, not 2 million, not 3 million. The alert that attracted, is it a good one? The alert that attracted the economic controller of Lagos State into checking the account. They called the woman and said, please, don't touch the account. Don't touch that money until we verify. Everybody was verified. He says, don't touch the money. This moment I enter and check the bank. Wait, don't touch it.
The system was confused. I don't do any business with anybody.
How come? They say, I don't touch the money. The bank. Don't withdraw. Don't withdraw. Withdraw. Don't put. The system waited.
I don't know. Bank can give order like that. Yes.
She did not touch the money.
They verified Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday evening. They called her and said, we are through with our investigations. It is your money, you can withdraw. Wow.
This is that time to testify. Eh? How much she dropped? She came to testify with 100 naira.
Yeah, that would be a turnaround. It has happened to one of my sons in the business.
There was a time I took him to the desert. I prayed for him. I prayed for him for complete 2 weeks. 2 weeks. I go to the desert two times a week with him. 2 weeks. And after that, something happened. Money entered in his account, 78 million. 78 million. But they're telling him to wait. But the name that paid the money, they took the name even a check it away. They tell him to wait for a whole 1 month, not to touch the money. Don't deposit, don't withdraw. For a whole 1 month, they were verified. Waiting. And they said, after 2 months, if nobody comes to claim the money, you start making the use of it. Start making use of the money. They waited 1 month and 1 week. Nobody came. They called him and said, we are through with our investigation. Till now, nobody has come to claim this kind of amount of money. We advise you to use the money gradually with sense. They can call you anytime. Your house address. This one. They collected almost everything from him. And then he called me and said, look at what happened. I said, what can we do? Since the money is in your account, don't just hold your hand like this. Do this. If you do, return back the money. This is heaven that put that money. And I expected him as a wise person. Whatever you are doing that time, keep paying your tithe. Support the work of God. And towards that time, he stopped coming. We did not complete the prayer. The prayer is supposed to be 3 weeks. We did not complete the prayer again. I stopped seeing him. As soon as they signed in the money, I stopped seeing him. He would withdraw the money, the first one, second one, they called him. They got to his house. And they said, stop making use of the money. There is right hand, that is handwriting on the wall. Stop using the money. Some people have come laying claim on the money. So wait. Don't withdraw. Don't pay me. Praise the Lord. He told me, I said, Daddy, no. Fire prayer. I said, no. This one is not firing prayer. The person that put the money has come to take the money. That is how they do the thing. They check everything. The men that pay the money, I give. They find. They say they see one. They say they move the money again, put it back. And they call me. They don't command the money. I say yes. They come out. And they need to come out. They got like it. He went. And they asked, they were asking, how did they say, no, we don't know, we just withdraw the money. You can use it. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Amen.
He said, tell me the people now, show me. He said, even me, you don't know the people, but you can use it. They said, we don't know. It's only that you can use it. The money, but they can't take it. Amen. Common thing that can open the door frequently. After that one,
He come get small wisdom. One contract come that will be giving him 500,000 every week. No, one after that, he came back. He begged God with 50,000. And God said, okay, since you bring 50,000, I'll be giving you contract that will be paying you 500,000 every week for a whole 2 months. The gain he will be getting every week, 500,000. And God said, you will be paying your tithe. The tithe of 50,000. Amen. And he started with it again. He started with it. He do it by now. 2 months. And after 2 months, God used me to turn and say, after 2 months, it will stop. He said, no, I want it to stay. God said, no, it will stop. Because that 2 months there, he will not complete it. He paid it for 1 month and 3 weeks. He stopped. The other one, he dropped the deal. God stopped the business. He came back again and said, brother, I want to sow a seed of 200,000. Pray again, let the thing come again. I closed my eyes. God said, if you pray, you answer yourself. I said, God said, no more prayer. Amen. But for 1 week, 1 month, and 3 weeks, he was faithful. At the time they come steady. They come free, say, no, because let I chop and first, let I chop this one. Because there are certain things that will happen. Things that you will need to do with money will surround you. If you chop that one way belong to God, you will end your lifting, beg it at a certain level. Amen. Yeah. One time when I was driving L300, I was so rich then, and we were about to travel for family relations. I said, I'm a man of God, let me use the tithe of the ministry to repair the engine. I used the tithe of the ministry, about 30,000, to fix the vehicle, the motor that we're going to use for family relations. I was using the motor for 1 week, running around Lagos, very sad. That day, we were about to travel. I drove out from my house, interspeed rain, from second number to Coca bus stop. The plug was dry. I pop. I changed the plug. I said, no, leave plug. I said to one of my sons, I said, go home. You will see me have packs of plug, about 12 of them, pack all of them. I pack the plug, run the plug, and I fix one. Start the motor, it start. We beat, yeah, get into reading camp. Two, box. The two plug, you just have, bah! The plug will boom. I lose the plug, fix the plug, I say, no problem. We fire again, get into Ijebu, the oil dry from the engine. I buy oil pump. We continue to buy oil, it's so the money finish. We start buying roadside oil. As I buy oil, as I buy plug. I said, let me continue until I get to Onitsha. Then I have ministers at Onitsha. I said, when I get to Onitsha, we'll pack it in the ministry, we'll find a mechanic that will work. After the bypass, I was negotiating on a high speed. Yeah. The next night, in oil on the ground, everywhere. I told myself, God, why did you do this? He said, why did you eat my pants? I said, but I'm a man of God, me, man of God, man of God, why? God said, my tithe is my tithe. I have no regard whether you are a man of God, whether you are a prophet. If you eat my tithe, you will pay, direct or indirectly. Nigeria become like Ghana. Money don't finish. And then, that day, on the 22 December, We were supposed to be at Soludo's house. Ex-Governor Santana. We were supposed to be in his house as this thing happened. I was calling everybody that I know. Nobody was speaking. We were there at 7 o'clock. We now finally saw some motor that pulled us from the church. No money again. I have to call Lagos. The brother said 60,000. We went to Pukaukosi. The brother that was going with us had an accident. Break his face, scratch everywhere. We bought the engine. Title, 30,000 back. We bought the engine. Fixed the engine. Start the motor. Get into Pukaukosi. Top cylinder knock. The top cylinder bomb. I said, God, why are you doing this? He said, why did you eat my bat? He said, if you eat, you will pay. Either you pay in my house or you pay in the house of the devil. Choose one. I said, in my house. He said, never finish paying. I will take it by strength. I managed to motivate to my house, to the village. Took the motor to our church, to Mary. They bring down the, they say, ah, okay. The top cylinder, he said, don't grant, we'll buy another one.
I said, what did I do?
I buy the gas cylinder, top cylinder. They grant it, buy top gasket, do everything, finish everything, start working with the motor. 3 days after, the top gasket born again. I went again, the pianist. As we finished all the operation, was coming back to Lagos. Get to Benin, the motor changed now. I buy this time around my oil. I buy 2 gallons of oil. I was the boy. I continue moving like that to get to Lagos, back the motor. She 2 days after I started wanted to go to the minister, what I am again. Praise the Lord. Since then, no matter what is happening, I don't use the title of God to joke. Amen? Some people may say, you be man of God, that's why they didn't do you like that. It can happen to anybody. What is happening to you now? Do you know why it's happening to you? Look at just 30,000. I spent almost close to 80 to 90,000. I cried that time. Since that time, I didn't tell if anything that came out, change. Come on the tithe. Come on the tithe before you give me. Come on. They will remove the tithe and say, okay, if you know the one way belong to me, put that. The one way belong to me, say, put it. Tithe of God, package out. If at the group and I said they close my eye, carry out. One man will tell me, you know what this amount can buy for you? I said, no one know. Before I go, I call my father the Lord. Once it is time to go and pay, I will call him on the money. But in the office, he said, yes, I'm coming to pay my tithe. If you don't see me coming. If you don't see me do what? Call me, save my soul. Because I have some battle with me. I said, God, carry the thing. If I don't move, that day I move 1 hour, I never reach hold up. They call me, he said, nah, carry me now. He said, I hold up with the nose, I'll see my change in my mind, you know? That day I went, after paying the tithe, he prayed for me. I said, I like the way you do. Because I have taken decision to turn from select, enter another road, and go back home. And the start I go back home, I will not give my wife the tithe again to keep. Because that time we were doing some work here. But as soon as they called me, I said, they come, I will. He said, they come, I will call you again. Praise the Lord. Amen and amen. I don't know what this whole thing. Why am I saying this? If faith will come, give God what belongs to him. You that is praying now, asking God, bless me, show me favor, bless me, show me favor. Do you know why that thing has not come? Because God will not trust you. God said, I'm not trusting. If I give you now, I will not see you again. So I still need you. I will not give you. I will keep it until I see your seriousness. I will give you. Amen. But we're not going to let this one again. We don't like the truth, but that is the truth. Amen. When you eat your, when you eat your own and eat the one of God, you have closed your door. Somebody gave you a connection to something and then you do this business. After doing that business, as a human being, you're supposed to be a sense to put something on everybody and tell the person, brother, thank you very much. Take this one. Somebody gave you a contract, a business you do, and have to pay of 100,000 and tell you to give him 10,000 and take 90. Is the man greedy? No. Everybody answer me. Is the man greedy?
No.
And about that, you eat the 90,000, eat the 10,000 again. What you're trying to tell the man, I eat it, what can you do? Amen. I hate that thing with the grace that I'm a man of God. But God did with me that is a God of the man. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
May heaven show us mercy.
Amen.
Let God open our eyes.
Amen.
He said he restored each man's money at the mouth of the sack. At the mouth of the sack. Can I tell you something? What keeps this ministry flowing till now? It's not too much prayer. It's not prophecies. It's not prayer. It's not prophecies. The prayer is there. The prophecy is there. But it's not the main thing that keeps this ministry flowing till now. You know what keeps this ministry flowing till now? Two things. Prayer, paying of the tithe, and what? Grace. This ministry, we pay the tithe of this ministry. Paying on the tithe and what? Grace. That is why this place is an open place. If I tell you how many times they have catch people coming to bury something here. If I tell you how many times they got people coming here to bury something. Sometimes we will come, they bury something here one day. I was praying, God said they bury something here. And I went there and prayed, I'm not going to know what you concern me. One day, what is mommy promise? Mama promise. This is my daughter. When you finish prayer here, you saw somebody. Somebody was coming with white. You told me?
Yes, sir.
Somebody wore white was coming into here to do incantations. And she jumped out and said, we are the message from that. Amen. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
If I tell you how many ministers that have stayed here. How many ministers that have stayed here, but they did not provide up to 10 members? The last person that leave this place, there are only four. Him, the wife, his friend, and one by four members.
Only two men.
Praise the Lord.
Amen.
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 Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
In this street, how many ministers are here? One was there, the left. This was there. Amen. Amen. But there is one thing that's keeping this place standing. So people say, let's put this ministers as if God did not protect his work. Who are you to protect it? One day, one of us says, we saw a lot of things. One man, they come here, carry brooms, sweep everything, back to the go. I said, let's continue doing the work we cannot do. It's working for us. I know that no man can scatter the work of God. The only way it will work, if I have ever went to anywhere to follow power, then what they are doing can work. But if I'm doing this work with my upright hand, they can't do anything. Because I know this ministry is very tight. And there is grace in this place.
Frustrate your power. Frustrate your power. Receive your man of prayer.
In the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
In the perfect name of Jesus.
Amen.
The second prayer point is this. As for many that is waiting to come at me, God of heaven, disappoint them one by one.
Amen.
Are you ready?
Yes.
My Father,
Settle.